My name is Hannah Whitaker. While I'm originally from Gainesville, Florida, I'm completing my Master of Science in Library Science at the University of North Carolina at Chapel Hill. I've spent my summer in Culpeper, Virginia, at the National Audiovisual Conservation Center, processing lacquer discs from the Universal Music Group collection. Now, you may be wondering what a lacquer disc is. Lacquer discs are recording blanks used in the production of 78s, 45s, and vinyl records. They're one of the earliest groove disc recording formats and were used primarily throughout the 1930s, 40s, and early 50s to capture live recording sessions. The discs were made by coating an aluminum disc or glass, as was used while aluminum was being rationed for the war efforts, with a thin layer of nitrocellulose lacquer. These blank discs were then cut into using a lathe machine, as pictured on the left side of the screen. The machine was able to transfer sound waves captured by a microphone, which was invented in 1925, into electrical signals, which dictated to the sharp, hot cutting head how to cut the grooves. While lacquer discs can range in size from 10 inches to 16 inches, most in the UMG collection are 16 inches. As you can see from the picture on the right, 16-inch discs are huge, much bigger than the 12-inch vinyl records we're familiar with. The age of these discs, coupled with the brittleness of the lacquer, has resulted in the unfortunate damage of many discs, making them a preservation priority. Lacquer discs that are nearly 80 years old, as many of the ones from this collection are, may be damaged. They may display signs of exudation, in which the chemicals used to create the lacquer coating begin to leach out. This appears as a whitish film, like the disc on the left. Some discs, however, have much more serious damage that require more in-depth interventions. Discs may be delaminating, in which the lacquer peels away from the edges, as depicted in the middle photo. Lacquer discs could be crazing, which is a severe form of delamination in which the lacquer becomes flaky, which has occurred to the disc on the right. Discs that are broken are inventoried and stored in broken disc housing, pictured here. An audio technician will inventory broken discs in a separate database specifically for damaged discs. Next, an audio engineer will assess what work can and must be done. Discs that display manageable levels of damage, such as exudation, may be cleaned in the audio lab. To clean a disc, audio engineers place it on a modified turntable called a Monk's machine and apply a 1% solution of ammonia using a soft brush. The disc is then dried, and deionized water is used to rinse it before it's placed on a drying rack. Finally, it's ready to be digitized. Some discs, unfortunately, are too damaged to undergo cleaning and conventional methods of digitization using a turntable with a stylus. These discs will be taken to IRENE, which stands for Image, Reconstruct, Erase, Noise, etc. IRENE is the most high-tech turntable imaginable. Instead of using a stylus to play music, a camera sends images of grooves to a computer, which can then play them as if it were a turntable. This invention has allowed for countless discs with no hope of digitization to be preserved. However, the solution does not always work, or may not sound as warm and clear as a disc being played conventionally, emphasizing the importance for continuous and preventative preservation of recorded sound materials. Through the dedication and ingenuity of archivists, technicians, and engineers here at the NAVCC, recorded sound from a century ago can be listened to by generations to come. I'm grateful for the Junior Fellows Program for providing me this opportunity. I would also like to thank my co-fellow Erica Cooley for being not only a coworker but a friend throughout this project, as well as my project mentor Patrick Midling for his support. I must also extend gratitude to everyone at the NAVCC, including, but certainly not limited to, Matt Barton, Brian Hoffa, Rebecca Jones, Ryan Kuntz, Keith Paramore, Patrick Smetanik, and Melissa Widzinski for their expertise and willingness to teach. Thank you.